हेलो स्टूडेंट, वेलकम बैक टू माय फिजिक्स क्लास. दिस इज लेक्चर नंबर 4 ऑफ अल्टरनेटिंग करंट, इन विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस ट्रांसफॉर्मर्स. इन ट्रांसफॉर्मर्स वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट इट्स कंस्ट्रक्शन, इट्स थ्योरी एंड इट्स एनर्जी लॉसेस. राइट, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट ट्रांसफॉर्मर विद इट्स इंट्रोडक्शन. सो व्हाट इज ट्रांसफॉर्मर? ट्रांसफॉर्मर इज अ डिवाइस which convert lower alternating voltage at higher current at into higher alternating voltage at lower current. Right? Or we can say this is used for converting large alternating current at low voltage into small current at high voltage. The transformer which convert low voltage into higher ones are called step-up transformer. While those which converts high voltage into lower ones are called step down transformer. Right? Transformer are used only in AC, not in DC. Let's talk about its construction. So this is the diagram of transformer. Transformer consists of two coils. As shown in this, two coil called P and coil S, right? These are called primary coil and secondary coil respectively. These two coils are insulated from each other and wound on a common soft iron laminated core, right? One of two coils has a smaller number of turns of thick insulated copper wire, while the other has a larger number of turns of thin insulated copper wire. In a step-up transformer, the coil of thick copper wire having smaller number of turns in this primary coil and the coil of thin wire having larger number of turns in the secondary coil. Right? This is as shown in this figure. This is primary coil and this is secondary coil. Step up transformer. This is step up transformer. And this is iron core. Okay? So in this transformer, the coil of thick copper wire having a smaller number of turns in primary coil. Right? And the coil of thin wire having larger number of turns in the secondary coil as shown in this figure. In the step down transformer, the order is reversed. I hope this point is clear to you. Now let's talk about its principle. Transformer is based on mutual induction. All of you aware of mutual induction? What is mutual induction? It is phenomena of inducing EMF in the secondary coil due to change in current in the primary coil and hence the change in magnetic flux in the secondary coil. Right? The given source of EMS, AC voltage. Given source of EMF AC means is always connected to the primary coil. Right, AC mains is always connected to primary coil as shown in this figure. When alternating current flows through this primary coil, then in each cycle of current, the core is magnetized once in one direction and once in the opposite direction. Right, so an alternating magnetic flux is produced in the core. Since secondary coil is also bound on the same core, so magnetic flux passing through it changes continuously due to repeated magnetization and demagnetization of the core. Right? By mutual induction, an alternating EMF of same frequency is induced in the secondary coil. The induced EMF in the secondary coil depends upon the ratio of turns, number of turns in the in two coils, right? Consider NP and NS are the number of turns in primary coil and secondary coil. Assume that there is no leakage of magnetic flux, so that the same flux passes through primary coils and the secondary coil respectively, right? Let phi be the magnetic flux linked with the coil. So the EMF induced in primary coil is given by Faraday's law, EP equal to minus NP d phi over dt. And EMF induced in the secondary coil is given by ES equal to minus NS d phi over dt. Right? From these two equations, ES upon EP equal to NS upon NP equal to K, where K is called transformer ratio or turn ratio. Right? For an ideal transformer, there is no loss of energy. For an ideal transformer, output power equal to input power. Output power ESIS equal to EPIP or ES upon EP equal to IP upon IS from this equation. Or we can write ES upon EP equal to IP upon IS equal to NS upon NP from this equation. Right? Efficiency of transformer, we know that efficiency is given by output power upon input power. So output power ESIS upon input power EPIP. For an ideal transformer, efficiency is 100%. Step up transformer. In this diagram, we see that number of turns in secondary coil is greater than number of turns in primary coil. So in step up transformer, number of turns in secondary coil is greater than number of turns in primary coil. That is, K is greater than 1. Transformer ratio is greater than 1. ES is greater than EP and IS is less than IP. Right? And in step down transformer, this is diagram of step down transformer. NS is less than NP. Number of turns in secondary coil is less than number of turns in primary coil. Right? That is, K is less than 1. Turn ratio is less than 1. ES is less than EP and IS is greater than IP. Right? Let's talk about energy losses in transformer. In practice, power output of transformer is less than the power input because of unavoidable energy losses. So these losses are, first is copper loss. Copper loss, heat is produced due to resistance of copper winding of primary and secondary coil when current flows through them. Right? As the alternating current flows through the primary and the secondary, heat is developed inside the copper turns. So this waste of energy is known as copper losses. This can be avoided by using thick wire of winding. Flux loss in actual transformer coupling between primary and secondary coil is not perfect. So a certain amount of magnetic flux is wasted. Linking can be maximized by winding the coils over one another. Iron losses. In iron losses, first is eddy current losses. When changing magnetic flux is linked with the iron core, eddy currents are set up which in turn produce heat and energy is wasted. Right? Eddy currents are reduced by using laminated core instead of solid iron block as shown in this figure. Right? Because in laminated core, the eddy current are confined within the lamination as shown in this figure, right? and they do not get added up to produce larger current. And in other words, their paths are broken instead of continuous one. While in this case, their paths are continuous. So that's why to reduce eddy current, laminated core is used. Okay. Next is stresses loss. When alternating current is passed, the iron core is magnetized and demagnetized repeatedly over the cycle, and some energy is being lost in this process. This can be minimized by using suitable material with thin stresses loop. Losses due to vibration of the core. Some electrical energy is lost in the form of mechanical energy due to vibration of the core, and humming noise due to magnetostriction effect. So I hope these points are clear to you. It was something about transformer. If you have any queries about transformer, just write in my comment box. Okay. Now let's talk about utility of transformer in long distance power transmission. If electric power generated at the power station, say 22,000 watt, be transmitted over long distances at the same voltage as required by consumer, say 220 volt, a number of disadvantages will arise. Right? The current flowing through the line wire will be very high, hence a large amount of energy will be wasted as heat during transmission, R being the resistance of the line's wire. The voltage drop along the line wire will be considerable, hence the voltage at the receiving station will be considerably lower than the voltage at the generating station. The line wires which are not carry the high current will have to be made thick. Such wire will be expensive and require stronger poles to support them. If, however, the power is transmitted at a high voltage, say 11,000 volt, all these disadvantages almost disappear that we have discussed, right? So the current flowing through the lines wire will then be only 2 ampere. This will cause much less heating, much less voltage drop along the line wires, and will require much thinner line wire. Right? So I hope you enjoyed this topic. In next video, we will learn about AC generator. Thank you.